My next guest takes on Lina Lansberg coming up here at UFC 229 on October 6th. It is Yana Kunitskaya joining me here on the program for the very first time. Yana, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Great. What did you get up to today? It was a Sunday. Were you training today or was it a rest day?
Yeah, it's rest day, but I was watching with my main coach fights of Lina, and we were speaking like about game plan and all the stuff, and then just I went to shopping, like rest my mind.
Right. That's good. You got a little bit of rest time in there, which is great. Of course, the big news is that you're now training in Las Vegas. What prompted that move, going from Albuquerque to Las Vegas?
Yeah, I'm really like training in Albuquerque, but it's very hard to live here. It's a small city. And also, my last fight was here in Vegas, and I was in UFC Performance Institute. And I find that it's like very good place. They're taking care of everything. So you don't need to think about like how to live, what to eat. They like preparing your food. I have place to stay here. So it's like much more easier to live in Vegas.
That's great. And how have you found it, training at Xtreme Couture? What would have been some of the benefits?
In Xtreme Couture, it's my manager, Ali, he told me that it's like good place and all the guys training here. I come to visit and I like it, especially that because of Institute, again, a lot of fighters coming here in Vegas and all of them going to Xtreme Couture. So it's always changing sparring partners with very high level. And I think it's very good.
Yeah, and that's good. Your manager was able to set that up. Of course, Ali is one of the top managers in the game. How long have you been working with him?
Since I started fighting in America. So it's like two years, yeah.
That's great. And I heard he'll check in all the time, which is kind of interesting. Not just about fighting, but he'll also ask about the personal stuff too. How much of a benefit is that?
Yeah, I think he like not one of the best. I think that he's the best manager
right.
in the game because he really taking care of his fighters, even outside the octagon, even with things what not connecting at all. So I think it's what make him like a very successful manager.
I agree with that. So let's talk about your last fight. Of course, you had that matchup, the title fight against Cris Cyborg at UFC 222. I know things didn't go your way in that fight, but what did you learn from that matchup?
I think this fight make me more strong mental because I was handling everything what worst can happen. Like it was short notice and moving weight class up, and it was Cyborg and Vegas main event. I mean, everything was like against me. So I think anything can happen after. It will be nothing comparing of what happened with me in this fight.
Right. And I'm sure that's a good experience to go through, too. High pressure situation. I mean, it's a very tough situation to compete in.
Yeah, sure. So I think it's going to help me in future.
I agree. I think that's good. Let's talk about this card, though, UFC 229. Does it add a bit more with the fact that this is in Vegas and this is on the Conor McGregor Khabib Nurmagomedov card?
You know, like, I'm so happy that I'm fighting here in Vegas because I don't need to move and it will be, like, weight cut much easier and, like, I don't need travel. I don't need to make this acclimatization. And I'm sure so excited that I'm fighting at this huge card. And especially that Khabib, my favorite fighter, and I'm so happy that I have chance to, like, fight the same card.
That's great. Let's talk about your opponent, Lina Lansberg. Of course, she also fought Cris Cyborg. How do you feel like you match up against her?
I think it's very good matchup. And it's third time when we should fight. I mean, when it was scheduled to fight. First time it was before the boss was in UFC. It was in Russia. Then it didn't happen. Then she signed with to fight Cyborg. Then we already was signed contract to fight in UFC, but then they signed me to fight Cyborg. So it will be our short time and it will be short camp when I'm preparing for her. And I think it's very good matchup and it will be interesting fight.
And we talked about your training camp a little bit there. What about training partners? Who are some of the people you get to work with?
As I told you, that good thing here because fighters always changing and it's high level fighters from UFC. So it's a lot of sparring partners and a lot of people help me. So like I'm happy in place where I am.
That's great. And how about the weight cut? Has that process started already getting down to 135?
Yeah, I'm started already and it's going good. I'm big girl for 135, but it's going good, and I'm sure like I will make weight as always. I never miss it.
Are you working with the Performance Institute at all? I know they give like nutrition plans out. Are you working with them?
Yeah, they give nutritionist, and I'm working with him, and they're preparing all the food, so I don't need to think about anything, just doing everything right as a thing.
Do you ever use the cafeteria at the UFC Performance Institute? I heard it's really good.
Yeah, it's really good, and nutrition is sending plan for me, so they're preparing food, make it ready, and just come and take it. And it's super nice because it's very healthy, and I don't need to account what I need to put in my food, and it's just amazing.
And the plan is to stay at bantamweight, right, at 135 pounds, or would you be open to going back up to featherweight?
No, I feel very good in 135, and I didn't like my body in 145. I still feel that I'm not lean enough. And in 135, I'm lean, and I'm recovery very good, because before Cyborg, I fought 5 rounds, so I was sure that I like it's my weight class.
Okay, that's great. Who's going to be in your corner for this fight?
My main coach, Ray Sefa, and like two other coach and sparring partner.
Okay, that's good. And how do you see this fight playing out on October 6th?
I feel that I'm more strong than Lina everywhere, with trying to work for everything and striking and wrestling and grappling. And I'm sure that I'm more strong than she physically. I'm more big, more strong, and I will be happy any situation what gonna happen. It's interesting for me to fight like in the ground or stand up, wherever fight will go.
What's next for you after this fight? I know you're not looking past Lena here, but is the plan to take a fight early 2019, or do you just want to space your fights out a little bit?
Yeah, I prefer to have 3 fights in a year, so like almost every 3 4 months. But usually, UFC not giving for me fights like this much fast. So I hope like after 3 4 months I can come back, because it's more easier to train when you have fight. It's like motivates you a lot, and it's very hard to wait like half year until something happen. So I hope I will fight soon.
Okay, and what are your hobbies outside of fighting? What do you like doing on your downtime?
If it's after fight, I like traveling to see the world. And in my camp, I'm not doing anything. I'm just training all the time, trying to recover. And weekend, maybe shopping. And here in Vegas, we're close to Los Angeles, so I'm going to the beach and enjoying just sea, sun. That's all.
Okay, that's great. Any plans to go back to Russia anytime soon, or do you just like staying in the United States?
No, I will go back to Russia because I have son back home, so I will come to spend time with him. And I have plans to bring him here in Vegas, so wherever I bring him, I probably I'm gonna stay all the time. I'm not gonna move back to Russia, but now I'm going after fight back here.
And I'm from Canada, and hockey is a big sport here. Did you ever watch hockey growing up in Russia?
Yeah, it's so popular in Russia.
Yeah, it's great. One of my favorite players, I don't know if you know him, Alexander Ovechkin. He just won
Yeah,
the
sure.
Stanley Cup.
Yeah, sure. Everyone know him in Russia.
Yeah, he's pretty popular. So that's interesting. Do you watch any American TV at all, or anything like that?
No, I'm not watching. Just in UFC Performance Institute, we have a running machine in front of TV. So and they're always playing American football. So I'm like forced to watch American football all the time.
Yeah, I know there's a couple big fans of football on your team. Is there any team you're rooting for, or do you just sort of watch it with everyone else?
No, I'm just watching like whatever who playing. I don't know.
Okay. Is it hard to follow, or is it do you find it's easy to watch?
I'm not like much like team games, but I'm just trying not to focus much and thinking about running, fighting. But I mean, when I'm running and watching football, but it's like I don't know, it's interesting, yeah.
Okay, fair enough. And we're looking forward to this fight. It's coming up here October 6th. It's UFC 229. Yana, it was great getting a chance to talk to you. Just remind people where they can find you on social media, and if you have any sponsors or thank yous, the floor is yours.
You can follow me on Instagram. It's Yana MMA. And like, I'm happy to see everyone here.